Good morning, it is Phoenix Amore. So now, I can basically reiterate to people why I don't mentor everybody with readings. Because just like ministry, when people are very cookie cutter in the way they see things, they miss out on some important details that you have to pay attention to. And again, when I say God selected certain people to be ordained in certain aspects of spirituality or religion, it's very real. This is why, long time ago, and I shared this story with people, I talked about there being this guy that I had dinner with. He decided he wanted to be a pastor. And what happened to him was, you know, he had all these years where he was raised in the church, but when he went to theology school, he went into complete shock because he was amazed at how many ministers and pastors were out there that only knew that surface level stuff. So he was blown away. He said, I decided I didn't even want to preach anymore. He said, how can I preach this stuff to people who will not really take it from me because they are so used to getting that surface level stuff? And he was real about it. I could feel him on that. He didn't know at the time, again, okay, this was actually on base on a contract. So this guy was actually a cis ad. And so we went out one evening and just had dinner and hung out a little bit. And he got into that conversation. Another conversation a man was meant to have with me, not realizing who, when I say who I am, you guys understand what I mean now. So with that being said, same kind of thing when you meet people who say they were called into ministry. I'm like, did you call yourself into ministry or did God? Because you do have some people who think if they just read the Bible and they know all the scriptures by chapters and all this kind of stuff that they are just ever so educated in religion. Not the truth. Because if you're not reading that with blessed eyes and ears, you're surface level. That's real talk. And people didn't understand that. So when God said, I want you to do readings. What? I'm raised Baptist. I'm not supposed to get all into that. What you saying to me? You are a prophetess. You're also, quote unquote, spiritual warrior. Now, some people, ha ha hee hee, until now, you understand when I brought all that terminology together. Sophia, right? The term goddess is what they use for her. But when you understand it's the theological aspect of it, that is basically saying this woman had the wisdom. And so when you talk about the eternal dance, understand it's just eternal movement. So you talk about infinity sign, you talk about dynamic balance and all that kind of stuff. So ironically, me loving the dance, when I understood what God was showing me, he was like, this is what I was saying before when he selects certain people to do certain things. It's embedded in me. This is where I'm talking about the natal birth charts and all that kind of stuff. And when it says stuff like cosmic warfare and all that kind of stuff, all that stuff, if you don't have blessed eyes, you're going, oh, he just, we think that, well, blah, unless you understand it at that deep level. Understanding now that Moses knew that word, the book of law. I told people, I said, if you don't know what that was, go look it up. The book of law was the original word, right? And then people started spinning off and interpreting things how they wanted to interpret it. So now, when I say the world card has this lady, Sophia, on it, if you've been raised in a Baptist church or some church where it's very surface level, you would be like, what in the, she talking, she into that witchcraft? No. Now you know sophiology is actually talking about wisdom. Sophia in Greek means wisdom, and it's on that tarot card. And if you understand, it's that last card of that major arcana. What that basically means, if you understood a long time ago when I talked about the Fool being the beginning of ascension, right, the spiritual journey, the Fool, when I explain to people, is like that very, that babe, right, babe in the word, if you want to call it. So that same journey through tarot from the Fool to the world is basically ascension. That's growing in the word. So when you understand that first song, when I said stay sharp in the word and God was saying to me, those are not butterflies, those are moths. So all these things, when the parables when God was using with me, like that's pretty, but that's not a butterfly, that's a moth. Moths destroy things. If you don't have discernment, you would think those are butterflies. All these things, when I talk about sparks and flames, he'll make the angels like the winds, the ministers like the fire. So all these things that came to me naturally because I was ordained with blessed eyes and ears, that's what happened. So for those of you who are reading some of the things and saying, okay, now as I'm piecing it together, it makes sense. You have to stay, if you are even chosen to be prophet, spiritual warrior, with the correct deity. this is what I explained to people before. Why I don't do medium readings is that very reason. Unclean spirits walking the earth. Guess what that means? That means you may be giving bad information because you listening to spirits talking to you. Whereas when I kept saying direct connect, I'm talking about Holy Trinity. I'm talking about being ordained to be able to see certain things. I'm talking about sleep state. So I don't walk around and see, I've explained that before, anything but what's there. But in sleep state, when I understood what God says in the Bible, why he spoke to people in dreams, because half the time, if you were to see some things in waking state, A, you get freaked out, or you're having to process it with this mind, which is in Lucifer's dominion. So understand that sleep state is when God himself can come in. So the night that I stopped breathing, when I was able to pull it all together, that was a time when I was depressed, brokenhearted, for real. I am not saying I'm Jesus. I understand the whole thing when the Bible said God will take you to the bottom, right? And for those of you that need to understand what that meant for me, making all these diplomatic decisions that people would often deem or perceive the wrong way. Understand the symbolism of exactly how Jesus had to go through that crazy stuff where it's like all he was doing was trying to heal folks. All I was doing was trying to be diplomatic. So foreseeing, again, how people perceive stuff. No, I don't want to always go over their house. They gossip too much. They'll be like, see, she thinks she all that. And no, y'all gossip too much. And I don't want to be around all that. That's the whole thing that people don't get. So when they say she's isolated and she's uppity or she thinks she all that. No, I understand biblically when God is like, keep around from gossip mofos because they can be toxic. So in that brokenhearted state, when I stop breathing, when I wrote in the blog, and you guys can laugh because it's very real how I write stuff, it was like God calling me saying, I know you are brokenhearted and you way down here, but I wanted to personally tell you, good job. So after all that, it did not matter who had what to say about my decision. That moment, God was like, you are actually doing most everything that you were supposed to do. Good job. Now, here's some more spiritual gifts. I have something else for you to do when you do it. So, giving me that strength, right, to now be able to present and say that world card, Sophia, on that universe, all these things that you did not understand, some of the church folks from that really deep word, Moses level, as we can call it, stuff, you guys didn't get it. So you'd be steady judging some of the folks that have had these natural gifts and missing out on a whole lot. So now people know when I said, I let people say I'm supposedly crazy. I even put it in the one post, right, where I said it didn't matter to me because when God pulled me personally to him and said, good job. Now, I'm gonna show you some more stuff. Do you wanna do this for me or not? I said, yes. I was already prepped for everything that comes with that. So all these people are like, how does she stay so calm with all these people coming at her sideways? Because I had that wisdom where I could say, now, if I come to you and talk to you about tarot, because of course, they always make fun of it because they don't even understand the whole philosophy, theology behind tarot, they have something to say. Those closed-minded people, they would not be apostles. If you really think about what I'm saying, that's why Jesus selected certain people. Closed-minded people cannot hear with blessed ears. Now you all get it. Take care.